Good evening. It's nice to have you back here tonight. And like we do it always, every night, we will ask God to help us to understand these things and to be alert. So we start with a short prayer. Our Father, we thank you for this day that you have given us. We thank you that you want us to help us now in this hour to understand the things that are important for our lives. And we thank you that you heard us and will bless us. Amen. So I will try to make a short repetition of what we studied until now. So a short repetition to see how we are built structurally wise. So as humans, we have a body. And in the body, the body is seen. Then we have a brain and a cortex in the brain, where all the nerves start. And then above the cortex, we have our spirit or our mind. And we saw that there is a connection in between. And we saw that the spirit gives the command so that electricity comes into the body and the body functions according to his command. And now there is a central point where the body and the spirit meets, called heart or subconscious. So we must understand that everything that goes into the body starts here. And everything that comes from the body gets here. So there is a central point where everything starts from and every information comes back. So when I have a thought of force, I get angry upon someone. Then from here starts a current that affects the body negatively. And you might get ulcer to your stomach. Stomach is somewhere here. And then this ulcer from the stomach comes back to your heart. And you feel the pain. And now again you have to take a decision. What to do about it? So it goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. For those who are Bible students, they will remember that in the Bible it is written that life comes from the heart. So this place where everything starts from and this place where everything goes must be known from us, because it is the center of everything we do. And Solomon the wise says, keep thy heart with all diligence, because out of it are the issues of life. Now how can you keep your heart if you don't know how it works? Can you keep something you don't know how it works? Can you?
Yeah.
Of course not. So there must be something that we understand about ourselves so that we can keep it. Oh, even the heart is subconscious, it's not so conscious for us. Obviously, Solomon knew how it worked. And Solomon wrote 12 chapters as a doctoral dissertation about the center of life. It's the deepest study of the human heart that you can ever find in this world written. It's in the book of Ecclesiastes. And that's not an easy book to read, but it's a book that will give you big insights of yourself. So in this heart, everything comes to the spirit. It comes there to get, is aware. And for everything that comes to the heart, the spirit needs to take a decision. But before he takes a decision, he must evaluate the information. And he evaluates the information according to a value system. And that value system is very simple. It's either gain or loss. So when something comes to you, your spirit needs to evaluate. And he can only evaluate to say, oh, this is gain for me or this is loss for me. He has a yes for the gain and he has a no for the loss. But before he comes to say yes, evaluates the loss or the gain, he must know how that works. How do I get a gain is the question. Do I get a gain by taking? Do I have the gain here when I take? Or do I have the gain when I give? Where do I have the gain? Well, we all think the gain is when we take. But is that the truth? Or is that the deception? You see, I haven't studied I studied Ecclesiastes to the end, but right now I study it again. Because I want to go a little bit deeper to understand the heart of man. And Solomon was not only the wisest man on earth, he was also the richest man on earth. At his time, Silver was considered like nothing. Only gold and above. He built himself houses, he says. I built gardens. I built irrigation systems. I had servants. I have had women. Everything a human being or a man would desire. Solomon had. And what's the conclusion he gets to? He says, everything is vanity. Everything is vanity. Why? Are you not searching to have a garden in the house? Are you not searching to have a wife or a husband? So what's wrong? Why does he come to the conclusion that everything is vanity? After he reached everything that a man can say he has in the world. You know why it was so? Because Solomon was living after this principle. He made everything with the purpose to take. And he came to the conclusion he cannot keep his rich places. I said, I worked so hard for all this. And I will let it to someone else who never worked for it. That's unfair. This riches, all that I have, I cannot keep it. And everything you cannot keep is vanity. You agree to it? What you cannot keep is no gain, is a loss. Only that what you can keep, only that which is never going to be taken away from you, that's gain. And that is what you give, not what you take. That's why in the center or the bottom of every decision we take, we either go with the purpose to take as a final purpose, that is, everything we do, we either do for to take, or everything we do either to give. Now we need both actions. We need as well to take and as well as to give. But and both things have the actions in them. Yeah, you take to give in the truth, and you give to take in death. So you have both actions in both equations. So everything reduces to the one or to the other. And now I want to show that we are born not knowing the truth. And I will paint, or I will try to exemplify how we are born. Because I think always when you can demonstrate something visible, you get it better. For me, I have to imagine things.
ယ်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သူ့စိတ်ထဲမှာဟူဆွဲလိုက်တယ်အဲ့တော့သူလည်းအဲ့လိုပဲထင
် Okay.So, we are born with the simple equation we give to take. We don't see the truth because it is hidden by the lie.So, how can you ever see the truth if it's hidden by a lie? Can you see it? No. So, it's impossible for us to see the truth if it's hidden by a lie.
အဲ့တော့အမှန်တရားကိုလိမ်လည်လှည့်ပြောမှုနဲ့ဖုံးကွယ်ထားတဲ့အခါမှာဖြစ်ခဲ့တယ
်So, in our lives, we think we give first that we might take. And we don't realize that that's not reality. Solomon didn't realize it until he gets to the depression.He had many things here that he took, that he worked for. He gave all his power to it. But when he realized, he could not keep it. And so he got depressed. He didn't want to do anything anymore.But then he realized that even depression is not right. So, the way I find out that this is wrong was according to the disease. You see, what makes us sick is the incapacity to keep our love source.It's our incapacity to keep that what we think is our need for life. But we need to keep it. There's a law that you have to keep and you become rich. You have to have gain. So, I was born like this.You are born like this. And as long as we are born like this, we are in a great danger of destroying ourselves. And in my life, my first spiritual need is harmony.
Harmony. ကလိုအပ်ချက်ကစီလုံးညီညွတ်မှု
You like harmony?
ခင်ဗျားစီလုံးညီညွတ်မှုကြိုက်လ
ား It's a little bit close to peace.
ငြိမ်းချမ်းရေးနဲ့နည်းနည်းလိဆက
် Yes, do we need peace?
ငြိမ်းချမ်းရေးလိုလား
Yes? Yes.
လိုလား
The question is just how do I get it?
တမိုင်းငြိမ်းချမ်းရေးဘယ်လိုရမလဲ
I was born in a family of a Christian family.
ခရစ်ယာန်မိသားစုထဲမှာမွေးဖွားလာတယ်
Four children in the family.
သူတို့မိသားစုမှာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ကလေးလေးယောက်ရှိတယ်
. I the second born.
သူကဒုတိယမြောက်ဝင်ခွာလာတဲ့သား
. But my parents were not happy people.
ဒါမဲ့သူရဲ့မိမာတွေကပျော်ရွှင်တဲ့မိသားစုမဟုတ်ဘူး.
They were living after this law.
သူတို့ကဒီဥပဒေရအသက်ရှင်နေတာ.
My father was not happy with my mother.
သူဖေကသူ့အမေကိုလည်းသိပြီးတော့ကျေနပ်မှုမရှိဘူး.
And neither my mother was happy with my father.
အမေရလည်းအဖေဘောပါရှင်းလင်းမှုတိတ်မရှိဘူ
း So they had these four children
အကလေးရလည်း၄ယောက်ရှိတယ
် And at the age when I was 8 years old my brother 10 my younger brother 6 and my youngest sister 4 and 2 they separated
သူမိဘနောက်ခွဲသွ
ား And I had already a lot of diseases until they separated
သူမိဘလမ်းခွဲသွားတဲ့အခါမှာသူ့မှာလည်းရောဂါတွေတော်တော်များတယ
် I had nervous tics
ဟာသူကဆိုလို့ရှိရင
် I couldn't speak well
စကားပြောတဲ့အခါမှာပြီးပြီးပြင်းပြင်းရော
ဂါ I was very often sick with my tonsils
Tonsil နဲ့တစ်ခါအမြဲလိုလိုဖျားနာတယ
် But when they divorced when they separated not divorced yet
အဲသူတို့လမ်းခွဲသွားတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့တရားဝင်တော့မဟုတ်ပေဘူ
း I got hepatitis B
Hepatitis B ဖြစ်လာ
Just 1 week after
တပတ်ကျော်တာနဲ့
because I was the most in need of harmony
ဘာဖြစ်လို့လဲဆိုတော့မိသားစုစီလုံးမှုကသူကအလိုအဆုံ
း and I was the most bound to my mother
သူအမေနဲ့သူကအခင်ဆုံ
း because I had to take from somewhere
ဘာတခုတနေအားနေယူရမှာ
yes we need a love relationship where we need to take
ကျောင်းယူနိုင်တဲ့မြစ်တာ
And mother is that first relationship. But when you need harmony, and your mother is not in a harmonious state, can you be satisfied? Can you?
No.
So, I was not happy. And so I was thinking with 8 years already,
ဒါကလည်းရှင်းနေရှိပြီသူစဉ်းစားတ
ယ် I was thinking the happiest thing in life is to have a good family
အသက်တာမှာပျော်ရွှင်မှုရနိုင်ဆုံးနေရာကတော့စီးလုံးညီညွတ်တဲ့မိသားစု
I thought that the needs of my spirit would be fulfilled if I have a good wife
အကောင်းတဲ့ဇနီးတဲ့တယောက်ရှိရင်တော့သူစိတ်ကချင်းနှမ်းလိုက်တယ်လို့သူထင်တယ
် Anything bad in this
အဲ့အတွေ့အမှားသလ
ား No So, at home I didn't find that harmony. So I married very early. I was only 18 years old. It's not a good age to marry, so don't follow this example. But obviously, my wife found me. And she was very fast. You know, women are sometimes fast. After 3 months, so what are we doing?
We're
getting married or not? I was 18. Very timid person. In need of harmony. So what can I say? So I say yes.
Okay, you ပြောလိုက်.
So I get married.
ဒါနဲ့လက်ထပ်လိုက်တယ်.
And I told you the other night.
ပြီးခဲ့တဲ့ညကပြောပြတယ်.
That my wife.
သူ့ဇနီးတွေကတော့.
Was not the fulfilling of my dream.
သူ့ရဲ့လိုအပ်ချက်ကိုမပြည့်စုံခဲ့ဘူး.
Because she was not the woman that I dreamed of all my life. Until 18 of course.
ဆွဲလာခဲ့တဲ့အမျိုးသမီးရဲ့ပုံစံမဟုတ်ဘူ
း. A quiet woman.
ငြိမ်ငြိမ်လေးနေတဲ့အမျိုးသမီး.
Know that.Makes his work at home. And has much understanding for you. Isn't that a bad thing? My wife is a wife that was born in the capital city of Romania. And people that are born in the capital city are very strange people. Because in the capital city, there is life goes faster than on the countryside. If in the countryside you go like this, in the city you, always in a hurry, always in a hurry. And so is my wife, always in a hurry. When she gets the train, when he starts already to go, she jumps in. Yeah, so she makes everything in the last minute. It's not something for the harmonious person. Harmonious person makes everything slow and is in time there and waits, you know. Now, I am there in this marriage. And I need harmony. And I think it must be given to me by my wife. I am not aware that I take it from her because I give to her, so I expect her to give me back.
Yeah?
So I expect from her, I expect to take from her. So after about 7 years, I realized there's a difficulty. But I am a Christian. And as Christians, you don't divorce. Because you have here a commandment that says you should not commit adultery. And there is no reason to divorce, just your wife is a little bit more fast than others. There's no reason to divorce that when you don't get what you want. So I said to myself, okay, that's my destiny. And I always was longing in my heart a better life. And when you long always to a better life, you might all outwardly keep the commandment, but inwardly you are another person. So I fell into many addictions. You see, the need must be fulfilled. You have no choice. If you need harmony, if you need love, if you need any of these and you need them, and if you don't get them where you think you have to get them, you get them in another place. So I get into the internet, I get addicted to movies, I got addicted to sports. And after almost 20 years of marriage, I was totally unhappy. You know, the more unhappy you are, the more the addictions become stronger. I never smoked, I never drank alcohol because I didn't like it. Maybe if I would have liked it, maybe I would have used that too to make my life harmonious. We took 5 children, 5 years before I wanted to separate. About 15 years in our marriage, we had a family in our church. They separated and they had 6 children. The youngest was 7, the oldest was 17. And since they had no one to take care for them, we took them all. It was an emergency. It was a very good thing to, from one day to another, you have 6 children. Four boys and 2 girls. I wish they would have been 4 girls and 2 boys. Because the girls, they are more diligent. You tell the boys to do something. No. I tell the girl. They more easily go to do something. However, there were 4 boys and 2 girls. And I really love the children, so to say. I gave them something, but I also want to take something from them. But in this time, our relationship didn't get better. You know, my wife did not become harmonious. She had the same pace like she always had. Even one gear more faster, because now we're 6 children there. More things to do. So I'm getting not depressed, but very, very unhappy. I'm getting so hungry to be happy. It's a feeling that you cannot describe if you have never went through it. So I was driven. I couldn't sleep in the night anymore. I considered sleep a loss. So after all these years, I did not want to separate because I wanted to keep the children. But finally, I decided to quit. I was 39 years old then, and I said to myself, if I not get now the right woman for me to get happy, I will never get happy. And this was in my mind, the family, the woman must make you happy. Anything wrong in that? I hope you say yes. Much wrong in this. But I didn't know it better. So I decided to separate the family. This was in 2003. And it should happen in July 26, the separation should happen, the moving away from the same place. So the children would go back to their mom, I go back to my mom, and my wife would go back to her mom. And so everyone should start a new life. But just before July 26, and the end of May, starting June, we went to have the last vacation as a family. And we booked a trip to the USA.
USA ကိုသူတို့သွားဖို့စဉ်းစားလိုက်ရဲ
At, for a family camp meeting.
မိသားစုသောစခန်းကိုသွားတက်ရောက်ဖို့
Because we met a family that were dealing with family issues and they gave me some hope that my family might be restored.
ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတော့အိမ်ဦးဆောင်နဲ့မိသားစုပုံကိုယ်တွေသူတို့တွေ့ရတယ်သူတို့ကလည်းသူ့အတွက်မျှော်လင့်ချက်ပေးခဲ့တယ်ခမည်းမိသားစုမပြတ်ပါဘူးဆိုပြီ
း So when I booked the trip I had hope that my family would be restored.
အဲကြောင့်သူကဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အဲ့ဒီတောစခန်းသွားဖို့ဆုံးသင့်လိုက်တဲ့အခါ
But when we
မိသားစုတို့တတ်တာလိမ့်မယ်လို့သူထင်ခဲ့
But as we started to go into this trip I knew it was not going to work anymore.
ဒါပေမဲ့ဒီခရီးကိုသူတို့စတင်တဲ့အခါမှာတော့သူ့မိသားစုတို့မျှော်လင့်ချက်မရှိတော့ဘူးဆိုတာသူသိလိုက
် The children knew there is no hope for our family.
အားသမီးတွေလည်းပဲငါတို့မိသားစုတို့မျှော်လင့်ချက်မရှိဘူ
း It will finish.
ဒါအဆုံးပဲ
In July 26.
July 26.
So we were the first June
2003.
We were at this family's home. And we were talking. The couple with us two, only we four. And they wanted to convince me I should not divorce, I should not separate. But for 3 hours, I stood steadfast. I said, no, there is no hope for me anymore. I want to find that woman that can make me happy.
အဲ့ဒါဘာပြောလဲဆိုတော့မဟုတ်ဘူးလေကျွန်တော်တို့ညှော်လင့်ချက်မရှိတော့ဘူးကျွန်တော်ပျော်ရွှင်စေတဲ့မျိုးသမီးကိုပဲကျွန်တော်ရှာတော့မယ
် So after about 3 hours of discussion
3 နာရီလောက်ဆွေးနွေးပြီးတဲ့နောက်မှာ
We finished
ပြီးသွားတယ
် And I left the place to take my tennis shoes to run because we wanted to do something with our teenager
အဲ့တော့လူငယ်တွေနဲ့လှုပ်ရှားမှုတစ်ခုလှုပ်ရှင်တာနဲ့သူသွားပြီးတော့သူ့ရဲ့ tennis shoe ကိုသွားယူတယ
် And on the way there there came a thought to my mind And that thought was, if you are going to keep my commandments, I will satisfy your needs. Oh, that was a happy thought. My needs should be satisfied. Harmony. But then I was thinking to the condition. The condition says if you keep my commandments. Now tell me, did I keep this commandment? I never slept with another woman. I didn't have any sexual relation with other women. But was I keeping the commandment? Or was it just a outer form. Did I love someone just to give? Did I? No, of course not. Even the children, I just loved that I should get something. So now I have this thought. If you're keeping my commandments, I will take care of your needs. 1 week passed, 7th June 2003. We are sitting together with the family and our children around. We are 10 people. And the gentleman was sitting like on this, my left side. And he suddenly puts me a question. And he says, Are you committed to stay with your family? And even before he finished, because I thought he will ask, Are you committed to leave your family? I said, Yes. So my yes fell together with the end of his sentence and the children were shocked.
yes ထူလိုက်တဲ့အဖန်နဲ့ဟိုကမေကုန်းမေးတဲ့လူရဲ့အဆောင်တွေကသွားကြိုက်လိုက်တဲ့ခါမှာကလေးတွေကအံ့ဩသွားတယ
် They were shocked because what did he change
ကလေးတွေကကြိုက်လိုက်တာဟာငါတို့ဖြစ်စိတ်တောင်း
သွား Is it not going to be over with the family
ဒါဆိုငါတို့ပြည်သားစုမကွဲတော့ဘူးပေါ့
And I saw their faces
သူတို့မျက်နှာကိုသူမြင်လိုက်တယ
် And I realized what I said
အဲ့ချိန်မှာသူပြောလိုက်တဲ့စကားကိုပြန်ပြီးတော့သူစဉ်းစားမိတယ
် And now I needed to take a decision The yes came out without real reasoning. But now I need to say, oh no, no, I did a mistake. Because you cannot play with these kinds of decisions. So I had to decide to take the yes back or to leave it there and stick to it. And I don't know how I did it. I believe because I did not want to lose the children. I sticked to the yes.
Yes, go, yes, I will have to be on the
yes. And in the moment, I stick to that yes. In my inner life, I took the decision to keep the commandment. In that moment, I took from God. And something in me changed dramatically. From a driven person, from a hungering and thirsting after love person, I got a peace that never left me till today. Because that peace that I got that moment. That's a peace that you cannot work yourself out. That peace you cannot put by laws down. That's a power that is not explainable. God, just like He is, in the moment I took from Him, He opened up the gates of heaven and gave me that what my heart needed. Like a thirsting person, I got without thirst anymore. I was drinking and I was satisfied.
ရင်ငါနေတဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ဟာရေတွင်းကိုတွေ့ပြီးတော့တောက်လာတယ်လို့ပဲသူတောက်လေဝါလေတောက်လေဝါလေနဲ့အဲ့ငတ်တဲ့ခံစားမှုရှိတော့
So when you are satisfied in your need
လိုအပ်ချက်ရှိတဲ့ခါမှာစိတ်ချနေတဲ့ခ
ါ Do you still need addictions?
ထလို့မလ
ား Do you still need addictions?
ထလို့မလ
ား No, you see all my addictions that I fight it with for more sometimes I mean, almost 20 years. I knew it was wrong, but I couldn't stop. All addictions were gone in a second. Never needed to go back to any of them. So I experienced something that I call the new birth. And what I experienced was this, something in my life, in my heart, was opened up a window. I could see a little bit of truth. Was I a new person? No, but I came to see a little bit of the truth. You see, when we are born again, we are babies. We just see a little bit of the truth. And so, I was very happy.
Thank you.
I took decisions in my life that I will never go back again to want another woman or to want a divorce. I took a decision that I will give my life for my wife and for the children to become as well saved, born again. But then a journey started in my life. Now, here, you have another direction. You take from God to give your wife. Here was my spouse. Here was my wife. I did everything so that she should satisfy my need. I took from her. So if you take something from a disharmonious person, how do you get? How do you get? You just get disharmonious. You see, my wife is stronger than me. Women always are stronger than yes? And she could always make me to do what she wants by weeping and by making me a hard time. And I wanting to be harmony and peaceful, so I made the compromise. I said, okay. Of course, I didn't say okay immediately. It took a few hours, but finally I was broken. I said, okay. You see, a harmonious person cannot stay on his own feet when disharmony is around. Because he takes from his surroundings. And so you get like the place you take. So I became not harmonious. I became nervous. I was not a peaceful person. But now, after this event, I realized that God exists. I realized that He is tangible, He's present. And so I started to learn from Him. I started to take from Him. Can you take harmony from God? Will you ever get this harmonious when you take from God? Will you ever? No, you can't. So God tried and started to teach me that I should give harmony to my wife. And if I give her harmony, my life is satisfied. Because you have the harmony in your body when you give it to the others. You don't have it when you take it. You see, when you take the apple or the mangosteen from the tree, is it in your body already? Is it there? No, only when you eat it, it gets into the body. And the same thing is in the spiritual life. In the moment you give the love and the harmony to the other one, that's when it gets into your body. So God helped me to change slowly. And you see, it goes like this.
One.
You have to take something off, and then you see new light. You see the truth like it really is. And so you grow day by day to become a harmonious person. You see, before we had a lot of arguments with my wife. Today we almost have no arguments. Because she is not my source for harmony. You see, sometimes even though you are the best husband, your wife might not be happy with you. She might be unsatisfied with me. But because you see, we are very busy, both of us. And women never get enough time from their husband. So whenever she has something on her heart, then she blames me, I don't have enough time for her. Now if I would take that personally, if I would take from her, I would enter into an argument. But so I say to her, my dear, speak to my boss. He makes my schedule. So pray to him and tell him he should give me more time for you. Because I'm not doing my own work. But let us enjoy the time we have. Let us not think about what we don't have, let us take what we have. Because you see, this selfish nature never gets enough. You can be the best person, the other one still finds something in you that you don't satisfy him. You understand that? So, taking from God means that you behave like God. You are in control of yourself. And you give out that what you take from Him. The problem is just, you're not aware when you take. You see, that's the blind spot. We don't see the truth that we take before we give. We just think we give before we take. But the truth is, every time before you give something, you took something. You have never, the Spirit has never something that He can give from Himself. Everything He takes from somewhere before He gives it. And I experienced this in my life in the last months more clear. You see, God wants us to realize where we take from so that we understand what we give. You see, the taking is invisible. The giving becomes visible because it goes into your body. And I tell you, I give you a short example so that we can understand what I mean. Just a few months ago, I was in my practice. And I took one patient after the other from the waiting room. But I opened the door to call the next patient in. And I sensed a smell. A not good smell. Now, I don't know how you are, but I have a very sensitive nose. Not a good thing to have a very sensitive nose. Better not be so sensitive. But I am very sensitive too. So I was thinking, who is smelling like this? However, I took one patient after the other, and finally the gentleman came in and I said, this is it. This is the man. He smells so bad. It was a smelling, I can't even explain it, like you go into a stall where you have horses or cows. And it might have been even urine smell. I don't know what it was. But the gentleman was about 55 years old, so he was not very old. But he was smelling terribly. Now, as an ENT doctor, he had a problem with his ear. He had an ear infection. And to treat the ear, you have to come very close. You cannot do it from here. So I had, with the microscope, I was working at his ear. And I got the smell. And I said, I have to finish fast this patient, so... But whenever I wanted to treat his ear, I came close with the instrument to take out the pus and what this was therein. He jumped away. So he didn't stay there to help him. So I want to finish fast. To start open all the windows. And he is not staying still. After about, I don't know how many minutes were passed, but I think about 10 minutes. About 10 minutes. I lost my temper. I can't remember in 11 and a half years that I ever lost my temper like this. Now, of course, I didn't boom, jump out. But I said to the gentleman, I said, look, we need to fix the ear. And you have to stay still. But it hurts. It doesn't matter if it hurts. You just stay still. You're not the child. Children cannot stay still. Well, it was not that bad like I show it here. But there was pressure in it. And finally, I put the head on that in the chair. So I fixed the head. So somehow I treated his ear. And I was ready. I said he should come next time earlier back because his ear needs treatment because it was a chronic infection. And while he was at the door, I was tempted to tell him, but please don't go into the stall before you come to the doctor.
Not
But I didn't say that. God helped me to not say that. But after he went away and I opened the windows and took care of other patients, at my break I have time to think. You see, I evaluate what I do. I go to God and ask him to help me to see myself. And I realize something terrible. While I was working, why, from whom did I take? Who was the source of my action? Was it the love of God? Or was it the impatience of that patience? Where did I take from? How do I know? Because you always know it when it comes out. You know, everything you take comes out. I became impatient. Why? Because my spirit took from the patient. My spirit became, so to call, he took from this man his smell, his impatient, and the same he became. When I realized that he became my source of action, I said, this cannot happen again. Because I don't want to take from a human to become like a human. Now, if the human is okay, you have no problem. If he smells good, no conflict. If he stays still when you treat him, no conflict. But you still take from the other one. So, in the conflict, we see where we're taking from. When the problem started with him, if I in my spirit would have went up to God and would have said, Lord, I have a problem here. Can you have any suggestions how I should proceed? Do you think the Lord would have answered? Do you think he would have answered? Yes, of course. He would have remembered me the law of life. He would have remembered me how love functions. Tell me, love, how much can it endure of smelling? How much can love endure a bad smelling? What does the definition of love say? How much does love endure? All! Oh, I can endure this smelling? It's terrible smelling. But don't worry, love make you powerful enough to endure it. Without getting impatient. You see, usually I'm very friendly to my patients. And when they have an ear infection, I ask them what they have in their heart, what the burden. But you see, this gentleman left my practice. And I didn't ask him what's in his heart. I didn't want to help him spiritually. I just want to get rid of him. because it was smelling so bad.
So
God would have remembered me, smell? No body problem, you can endure it. And I would say, okay, now how can I do this with his reactions, that he does not stay still? Well, the love of God would say, can you understand him? Maybe I understand him. It's hurt, it's really hurting. The ear is very, very sensitive. So, with the attitude of love, I would have solved the problem without getting out of me and patience and no control. Did I get some sickness of this issue? You see, I am so sensitive. From such a conflict, I get sick. One day or two later, I either get dizziness or earache or stomach problems, something comes out. And I thank God for it, because it helps me to see that I took from the wrong source. So the main question that will settle everything in us, our life, is after whom do you orientate your decisions? And from where you take, from there you orientate your decisions. If your spouse is where you take, then you will decide like your spouse. If your friends, your patient is there, you will take from your patient. If you have your colleague at work and he's in a bad mood and you get through him in a bad mood, then you take from him. If your parents are where you take your love from, your orientation, then you will act like your parents. Because the law of life can never be changed. From where you take, that is what you give. And imagine we would have understood the law of the Ten Commandments. We would have understood that God is the only source where we can orient ourselves after. If God is love, what would come out of us? What would come out? Love. You see, we always can measure a person according to his actions. If they are loving actions, he must have taken them from God. Because every good thing comes from God. Everything good a person does, he must have taken it from God first to do it. So imagine if Christians who understood the Ten Commandments would keep the commandments, that is, would take from God and give to their fellow people. How would their life be? How would their life be? How? Are you with me still? What kind of life would it be? They would just be in character, in love, like God. You see, John, the beloved disciple, says, he who does not love does not know God, because God is love. And if a Christian says he's a Christian, but he does not love, what is he? A deceived person. Our diseases come because we are not capable to love. I was not loving to my patient. Why? Because he became my orientation of action. I didn't love my wife because she did not be like I needed it. In 12 years and a half, I learned to love. I learned, I'm not yet there, but I learned many things to love. But whenever I get confused in my heart, and I take from my wife instead of from God, I become like my wife. You always become from where you take. That's why the way you are shows where you take from. That's in every moment, since the Spirit must take every moment, every time He needs the information and orientation. We might be at every moment tempted to take from the wrong source. That's why we need to become aware where we take from. Because you see every action that you do in your consciousness. And I repeat this 1,000 times because that's what you have to learn. You either do it with the purpose to take at the end or with the purpose to give at the end. There is not more in human motivation than that. There is either love or selfishness. There is not two other possibilities. I tell you another story of a patient of mine who has depression. And he has this depression because his spirit unconsciously takes from his environment, from his family that is not the best family. And he calls me once and said, I have a problem. Whenever I make an appointment with a friend, and the friend does not come to the appointment, and after half an hour I call him and I don't find him on the phone, I get very nervous. And I don't get peace until I find him sometimes and reproof him. Can you understand him? Did it happen to you? Went to an appointment? A person didn't come? A pleasant thing? No. So I said, your case is very simple. You see, when you know where everything starts, you can solve every case. So tell me, why did he make the appointment? To give or to take? What was the purpose why he wanted to meet his friend? To give him something or to take something from him? What was the purpose? How do we know it? It's obvious. He went, he made the appointment to get something from his friend. Because when the friend didn't show up, who has the loss? Who loses? Himself loses, yes? And so he must get angry because we cannot say in loss, we have to say no to loss. So he gets angry because the other one brings him into loss. Now imagine he would make the appointment just to give. And the friend wouldn't show up. Would he get angry? Would he get angry? No, why not? Who loses? The friend loses. He loses nothing. So he may call and say, oh, what's happened with you? I'm sorry, because you lost something. You didn't come to the appointment. You understand the problem? Why are we doing what we're doing? That's either love or selfishness. Now, selfishness doesn't make you sick when the other comes to the appointment. Selfishness only makes you sick when the other does not come to the appointment. But love would never make you sick. Neither when the person comes, nor when he does not come. Because love would have never something to lose. Is there any question, did you understand this principle? Can you remember last night I spoke to that couple with the I self? The I self you need to see where you take from. And the bread you need to eat from the bread. There is something in us that makes us blind. And that which is in us needs to be taken off.
Step by step.
Step by step, it must be teared down. How can that happen? What is the means that breaks the lie away and shows the truth beneath? The only means that God could have for this is that what the Bible calls the cross. Before you can have a new life, the evil perception, that what covers the truth, must be taken off. It must die. So that you can see the truth that is beneath of it. You see, the truth can never be taken off. But the lie is over it, so you cannot see it. You just, every time the spirit looks to his motivation, he just sees the lie. He does not see the truth. And this is a process we need to go through until everything that is blinding us is away. And in all our actions, we are clear where we take from and where we give. Then can happen whatever can happen. Your mother might die. She might die in a young age. She might die suddenly. You are an adult. Will you get sick? Maybe the first 2-3 days you're very, very surprised. You are in a problem because you realize that you take from your mom. But after you see what happens in your life, after you see that you weep without stopping it, and you see and realize that your thoughts go always around your mom because he died, it's because your spirit has no place to take anymore, because mom was the place to take. Just for Christmas, I had a lady who came and she says, I have some voice disorder. My voice doesn't work well. And so, of course, when she tells me that she has some voice disorder, I know where to look. Do I? Everything that the spirit gives goes into the body. And when he gives love to the body's voice functions perfectly. And so I looked into her in my papers. Because she was several times at my practice. And 2 years ago, she told me that her mother is sick. So I asked her, how is your mother doing? And she said, my mother just passed away at the beginning of January, that was in December, so a year now her mother is dead. And so I asked her, how often do you think on your mom? What was her answer? Every day. She cannot stop thinking on mom. Why not? Because she has not to give her something? Or because she has not to take something? What brings the spirit into trouble? That he gets not, he's not able to be loving. You know what it is? Because he takes from mom. I have patients who cannot raise one day to not think on their mom. Are they healthy? Healthy? No. Diseases come one after the other. At the beginning, you have a little bit of voice disorder. But if the lady does not stop taking from mom, she will have in, I don't know, 5 years, 6 years cancer or whatever disease it can be there.
ဒီပုံကဒီမျိုးသမီးအားဆိုမိခင်ကိုအများအားမိဝဲနေမယ်ဆိုလို့ချင်းနောက်၄-၅နှစ်ဆိုလို့ချင်းကင်ဆာဆက်ဖြစ
် Because unconsciously the source of her life is gone
ဘာဖြစ်လဲသူ့ရဲ့အတ္တရဲ့အရင်းမြစ်ကသိဆုံးသွားတာ
She does not have her mom where she belongs
သူ့ရဲ့မိခင်ရှိရမယ့်နေရာမှာသူ့မိခင်ကမရှိတော့
She has her mom on the place where God belongs
သူ့ရဲ့မိခင်ကဘုရားရှိရမယ့်နေရာ
She loves her mom with a love that only you can love God with. That is to take. So, we need to see that the spirit is desperate for love. And he searches continuously for it.
မချမလာအမြဲတမ်းဒီမြတ်တာကို
Because he needs to take continuously.
မချမလာရယူဖို့လိုတယ
် And what he takes he gives.
သူရယူမှများကိုသူကပေးဆက်တယ်.
That's why we need to be aware where we take from.
ဒါကြောင့်ကျွန်တော်တို့ဘယ်ရရယူတယ်လဲဆိုသိဖို့
And crisis and diseases helps us to see it.
ယတနာတွေယောဂါတွေကကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုကျွန်တော်ပြန်မြင်အောင်လုပ
် That's why I love disease.Not because I love disease. But it can enlighten the spirit of the person who is sick. To see the deception of the heart. And to go to the cross to remove it. To see the truth.And follow the truth. A last example. A 72-year gentleman gets a neuralgia of his left trigeminus nerve. Did you ever have teeth pain? Tooth pain? Yes? Is it a pleasant thing?
အဲ့တော့ရှိလာတဲ့အခါမှာကြိုက်လာလို့ရှိရင်သက်သာမှုရှိလာ
You like it? No one like tooth pain. But imagine now you have it on all three things. The nerve is just like a current is boom, boom. It's very, very painful.
တော့ဘာလဲဒီချိန်မှာသုံးနေရစလုံးမှာအကြောကဆောင့်တက်လာပြီးတော့ကိုယ်လာဆောင့်နေဆိုပါစို့
And you have this pain for 6 years.
ဆောင့်နေလုံးအဲ့လိုကြိုက်
You are almost ready to die better than not solve the problem. And usually medication does not work with it. So the patient even was got surgery. They open up the skull to see if the nerve was somewhere irritated so to help him to get rid of those pains.
အဲ့တော့အကျော်များတစ်ခုဖြစ်လာဆိုပြီးတော့သူတို့ခေါင်းကိုခွဲပြီးခေါင်းခွဲပြီးတော့သူတို့ရှာတယ
် After surgery didn't avail nothing.
ဒါပေမဲ့မတော့
And so he went to a pain medical doctor.
ဒါနဲ့နာကျင်မှုဝေဒနာကုတဲ့ဆရာဝန်တောက်ရှိ
And she gave him 3 very strong medications to die to anesthesia.
ခဏလေးညင်သွားအောင်ပုံလုံးတိုက်လိုက
် And he took these medications and
အဲ့ဒီဆောင်းကိုသူတောက်လိုက်တဲ့ခါမှာ
He was very happy. His happiness lasted only
ဒါပေမဲ့သူရဲ့ပျော်ရွှင်မှု
When instead of pain started to be dizzy.
ဒါပေမဲ့ခေါင်းကမူးနေတ
ယ် Feeling? Nice feeling? You like it? I know this feeling.
ဆရာကြီးကတော့ခေါင်းကိုကြိုက်လာခေါင်းမူး
Comes with dizziness to my practice.
ဒါကခေါင်းမူးလို့ပြ
ော The cause of his disease?
ဒါတော့သူသိလားသူသိတယ
် I know exactly.Pain years and why now he come from
yoga
tell me spirit from the heart a source of love his spirit because he needs and I tell you his story his mother died 12 years before his father diedso 22 years. And he has this custom. He's a Catholic. He goes every commandments, you know. Christians, no matter what they are. But after the church, every Sunday to the
seminar.
And I talk to them. I tell them what week and what I did, all that what he did. I tell them everything, he just good word to God for him. And then he goes home. And he's doing this. Would he ever think that that man the cemetery to give, he went to take. His love source, who? His mom told him the Ten Commandments. I'm to him. And as there is a deception, take from. Can your meat, when she's dead, can she? Can satisfy your need when he's not dead? Yes or no? No. Give him the Ten Commandments and as. You need leave from here and put God and put your mother and. Where they belong? Would he need? Would he need to go there? No, of course not. What's to a dead person? There we can give enough. What did he say? Thing to do? Oh, doctor, tomorrow I start. That's how. Impossible. As long as you want. You need the cross. You need to understand. That stops your way first. I ask God, if he chooses of his mom, God, would disappear. In of the face, because the spirit from God bring to all those found his place and eating. System that is would find just electricity would be perfectly. Question is, where do you take from? Like you can never take from outside. That's for sure. We always get aware in trouble. So crisis and trouble realize. More than 90 diseases come from our heart. Because we take, yes, unconsciously, with the best intention. And by we might realize a place where we can get help. And tomorrow night I teach how that happens. Solved the problem is evil can see the truth by the truth. Tomorrow night, pre-last night, Monday morning at 11, we'll love. What is love? What we need to give that we might be always and healthy. Solution is still to come. But I hope you may unite. Who orientation? From where you take, that's you become. From whom you, after you, that's your God, you will be. Nice. That you inclusive source. Are there any questions for? I know a lot here, so you might be tired. Did you try to share a? You will need to think a lot of it. I'm thinking daily because I need to it's very simple, but impossible of the deception that we have in us. It is taken so that the so no them down. Maybe for maybe you understood everything. Maybe you just immediately. So, if you want.
မိမိစိတ်ထဲကလင်းလင်းမြဲသွားတယ်။အင်းတော့ခါကိုရီတာအင်းတို့ချက်ပို့ဆောင်ပိတ်ဆက်လာကြတော့ခွင့်ပေါ်နေတော့ခါပြန်လဲလို့ထားမလက်ဖြံအချိန်တည်းနဲ့ရောက်ရှိလာခွင့်ခရစ်တော်ရဲ့မဟာနာမ
So, have a good night.